Some people have been asking me what I carry on my bike and how do I carry it all. Well, here's a display. I'm getting ready to take off here in the next day or so. I got some riding around in the front range to do, and I'm going to explain to you some of what we got. First of all, it's the basic necessities: food, water, shelter, and clothing. We'll start with the shelter. Brand new tarp tent. I just got this incredible single wall tent. Lots of ventilation. Lots of ventilation. Extremely durable. Super easy to pack up. And lots of room for its weight. It weighs 30 ounces. And we got my Richie bike here. My Richie P Team. It's awesome. It's loaded with Axiom waterproof panniers on a Blackburn rack. I've got a Revelate Terrapin tail bag, and I have a Ranger frame bag. This bag is phenomenal. Bike Shop Hub in Tucson helped me dial one in that fit the frame perfect, and Blue Dog Cycles in Tucson helped me pick out the Revelate. Just got some new Flow wheels from Stans, some Avid BB7 brakes, got a 48-ounce water on a Salsa Anything rack. Inside the frame bag, I've got a 3-liter Nalgene, and I've got a Roadrunner tank bag and a Revelate feed bag. All works really, really well. Here we got my MSR stove and my GSI cup and / pot. That's about all I cook in anyway. I don't cook a whole lot. This GSI drip coffee filter, it just seems to work. I bet there's better ones, there's cooler ones, but you know what? It's durable, it works, it packs away, it's awesome. Okay, back to the tent. Tarp tent, pro trail tent. It's the Sil Nylon fabric is super light, super durable. The feel of the fabric is almost deceiving. It feels strong and heavy, and it's the whole tent with poles and everything is 30 ounces, less than 2 cans of cheap beer. And we got the Climate V Ultralight SL. I did a post about this earlier. I showed some pictures. If you go into my profile, you'll see 12 ounces. It is essentially the same size as a can of beer. 11.9 ounces, can of beer is 12 ounces. They both fit comfortably in a pedal to the metal can koozie if you're interested. Spot on my page, you can order that. Western Mountaineering sleeping bag. It's a 35 degree bag, but if it gets any colder, I shouldn't be there. It compresses down really small, weighs 1 pound. Made in America as well, just like the tarp tent, made in America. Good stuff. Western Mountaineering is my choice just because of the longevity of their product. They've been around forever. I've owned several. The great product. You can never go wrong. I dig it. If it gets colder than 35, over here in my clothes, I have a smart wool base layer, top and bottom. I've got a pair of outdoor research pants. I've got a couple t-shirts, socks, underwear. My down puffy jacket is in here. It looks big and bulky, but it actually serves as my pillow at night. Mountain Hardware rain gear. Few miscellaneous electronics I try not to use a lot. Hey, how about a can koozie? Anybody want a can koozie? A couple extra tent stakes. I got my CD shoes, man. These CDs were brand new just a couple of months ago in Tucson, but I wear them right out. I need a new pair. Anybody know where I can get a good deal on a new pair of CDs? That'd be great. Pearl Izumi toe covers. If it's chilly or there's a little bit of rain, they're a soft shell material. They help keep your feet a little drier and warmer. My Bell helmet, of course, could save my ass one of these days. I hope to be wearing it if necessary. Helinox Chair 1. This thing is the best 1 pound I could carry. Super small. It rolls up about the size of 2 cans of beer. Cans of cheap beer. Great way to categorize volume and some of this stuff. Most of it's really small. Yeah, and as you see, you know, the climate, the Zion Canyon edition, it's phenomenal. No complaints. Over here, we've got outdoor supplements, ass end, time to play. This complete outdoor formula is a pre-workout, is energy, is hydration, is endurance, and it's got a great taste. This peach mango, it tastes so good you might want to drink it all the time, but if you don't have something to do and you drink this, you're going to find something to do. How's that? I got some pedal to the metal stickers here if anybody's interested as well. A bicycle lock. Important stuff, man. You know, it's not a big expensive lock. I'm of the philosophy that if somebody wants to steal my bike, I don't think a lock is going to save it. So I try and keep it smaller volume. As far as tools, here we go. I've got a tube of part grease in here and a couple other, and some ball bearings. I like to maintain my own hubs and bearings on my bike. I've got some miscellaneous parts and tools in here. My Crank Brothers multi-tool works, tire levers, valve tool, Spyderco Delicata knife, or Delica, a few miscellaneous patch kits. You wonder what a sewing needle and dental floss, multi-purpose, right? But if you ever get a gash in a tire that you can't fix, sew it. I have had to sew tires. I can reference some pictures from the last time. It was in South Carolina near Hunting Island Beach, or Hunting Island State Park in South Carolina. I had to sew a tire because there was a bunch of shrapnel on the road. Stove. This is super small. This stove folds up so small. These cans of fuel, they last. If I cook even twice a day on this stove, I can get almost 2 weeks out of one of these canisters of fuel. And a canister of fuel is about $5. Silverware, eating utensils, toilet paper, Volet straps, man. Volet straps are endless. If you see my Nalgene bottle on my Salsa Anything cage and holding my Blackburn Mammoth 2 stage, Volet straps. They're like bionic bungee cords, man. They really work. Got a net on the rack. Hold anything else if I need to carry some extra items or move some things around to carry some extra food or water. Shower bag. Anybody know what this is for? Leave no trace, you know? I learned it very young. I have no problem digging a shallow pit when I gotta go outdoors. That way things aren't blowing around, animals aren't getting to it. Whatever, doing my part. I don't want you to see that I was there anyway. Got stands, tire sealant, man. The only way for me. There was a recent review, I think I posted it on Pedal to the Metal, about tire sealant reviews. Stands is still number one. Finish line, dry lube, a little bit of electrical tape, three-way wrench, a little bit of cordage if I got a bear bag. I know there's at least 50 foot there. Sawyer mini filter, okay? These filters, it's the only filter I use. It's not a pump filter, but it will work by gravity. If you have two bladders and some extra hose set up, which I have some spare hose and I can do that if necessary. But yeah, I can pull water out of some wretched places with this Sawyer filter and not afraid to use it. Some mace, dogs, or God forbid, a bear. And over here, yeah, we got some more Pedal to the Metal merchandise. Hit up my page if you're interested in koozies, stickers, or buttons. I've got some vinyl decals, but Schwalbe tires, man. Great, great, great tires. I generally don't spend a lot on tires. I look for whatever's cheap. If there's a bike co-op around, I'll buy cheap tires. Yeah, people ask me why I still ride a 26-inch bike. I ride a 26-inch bike because it's comfortable for me, and it goes where I want it to. Legendary Richie Logic tubing and fabrication. This bike has been through hell and back a couple times. My good old Brooks saddle. This place has been a lot of places. Yeah, there's a lot of sweat on that saddle. We won't talk about that anymore. The Roadrunner tank bag, phenomenal bag. You know, a couple snacks in there, keep the phone in there. I do have a phone case. I do have a cat eye padrone and a Lazine light. I try not to ride a whole lot at night. You know, my 3-liter bladder that's in my frame bag. I have a drinking nozzle coming right out. I don't even have to pull off a bottle. And I can't stand carrying backpacks. That's a personal preference. Some people are okay with it. I don't care for it. This dry bag here, all of my clothing, the tent, sleeping bag, and mattress all fit in that bag and get mounted inside this carriage right here. And it's completely waterproof, completely compressible, and really helps balance the load. I can get a huge amount of stuff in there. It's got a blow-off valve so that you can push air out of it as you're rolling it up, just like you would any dry bag. It's just tailored to fit inside this carriage. Really, really great design. Revelate did a phenomenal job. I don't know as though I could be sold on much else. As I said, the Ranger frame bag is from Revelate as well. Great, great American made. Yes, made in Alaska. 1, 2, 3 components made in Alaska. The Roadrunner bags are made in Los Angeles. The Axiom bags are a Canadian company. I think they're made overseas, but they are completely waterproof. Lots of room. There's about 27 liters between the two bags. And nice little side pockets as well for storing quick grab stuff. The Avid BB7 brakes. I've always run hydraulic brakes prior to this. And this is my first time running cable disc brakes, but I think I have a mechanical advantage now. Hydraulic brakes tend to need bleeding every once in a while, and this mechanical advantage is I carry a couple of cables and I can do them myself. Just put them on. Cherry bomb tail light. Man, you can see this thing forever. It's got a great strobe effect to it. Kudos to Knight Rider on that. But other than that, quick tip or quick bit of information. My tent, sleeping bag, and mattress combined only weighs just over 3 pounds. Just over 3 pounds. And I can fit it into a quite small stuff sack all by themselves. As I said, all these clothes, okay, these two bags of clothes, my rain gear, the tent, sleeping bag, and mattress can all fit in that Revelate tail bag, the Terrapin bag. Phenomenal. You just it takes a little time to get used to, but phenomenal. Back to the tarp tent. You see it's single wall and it's got a lot of mesh, okay? Allows a lot of great ventilation. I don't have it pulled out all the way out right now. I'm not really worried about it, but if I were going to be in some really dense humidity or heavy winds or maybe not any wind or very little wind, I'd stake it out. It'll allow a little bit of ventilation. See the tail end over here? There are flaps that I can fold down and they snap. You can do it from the inside. It's phenomenal. The only moving part on the tent is the zipper for the door. All right? Phenomenal. This is great. Minimalist. Okay? One zipper with metal poles. Really tough zipper. I put some McNets on it. Zipper lube, phenomenal stuff. The bathtub style floor is on the tarp tent is phenomenal. As I said, I just got this last week. I've read great reviews. I've been wanting something even lighter and more durable than what I had last. This was my answer. And you know, made in America. Phenomenal tent, some extra tent stakes here. What am I missing? If you have any questions, Shimano XT drivetrain. If you have any questions, feel free to inbox me or start a topic, start a discussion, ask to see some more, and I'll gladly do that. Other than that, I think it's getting ready to rain. I'm gonna pack this up and post this video. Have a great day. Pedal to the metal.